know, we don't serve a God that lies. You know, every promise He has kept. You know, I've said it before, He's not just a promise maker, but He's a promise keeper. You know, and so everyone He has already kept. You know,
absolutely.
And that should give us the strength and the hope to hold on to sometimes. Remember, we go back to that knowledge thing versus feeling. Mm-hmm. Knowledge. Who am I?
That's right.
The child of the Most High God.
Right.
Does not lie.
That's a good segue into my next scripture. 2 Thessalonians chapter 3, verse 3. It says, but the Lord is faithful. Let me back up to verse 2. Verse 2 says, and that we may be delivered from unreasonable and wicked men, for all men have not faith. But the Lord is faithful, who shall establish you and keep you from evil. Right? I don't have to have the strength to fight everybody and every demon and every enemy that comes at me. I don't have to. Because it says, God is faithful. He is the one that's going to keep me from falling into that. If I keep my eyes on Him and I follow Him every day, it's not always easy. And it's easy to get distracted by the fear. And we'll talk about some of the protection scriptures next week or the next lesson. But He's faithful. Like you said, He doesn't fail us. He's not going to, it's not sometimes when the scripture says, I will uphold you and I will help you. It doesn't say I will sometimes do it. It says I will. That's a promise. That's for everybody. That should excite everybody in the church. I mean, I think, why can't everybody get as excited about some of these scriptures as I do? Because I go, man, that's exciting when I think about the fact that I don't have to worry about the enemy, right? I know there was a time after I battled the illness that I had that, you know, the enemy would come in with trying to make me worry. But I knew God had healed me. And it's scriptures like these that say, I don't have to worry about it coming back. I don't have to. He's got me. And I want to close with this one, Philippians 4:13, which we probably all know. I don't have to read it because I don't want to mess it up. It says, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. There isn't anything He calls us to do that we can't do because He gives us the strength to do it. There's so many times I hear people say, I just can't do that. Can't is not in God's vocabulary. I just can't. We can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. I can remember there was a time I was stranded on the side of the road with the car with a flat tire, and I thought, and I did everything. I fought with those lug nuts and fought and fought and fought and fought, and nobody was stopping. It was a hot day. I was out in the middle, and I was like, I'm going to get run over, sitting here on the side of the road. I was like, oh. And I thought, I don't have a phone to call anybody. This was back before we all had cell phones. And I don't have any family here. This was before I was really in an established church, you know. And I thought, I don't need anybody. God is on my side. And I grabbed a hold of that lug wrench, and I went, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. And it broke loose. Bam. Every one of them broke loose. I didn't have to have anybody. I changed that tire on myself. I got done, and somebody stopped. And I was like, I need you. I got God on my side. I don't, you know. It's one of those things that, you know, sometimes we just gotta use the word to convince ourselves. I didn't have the strength to break that lug nut loose. There's no way. Y'all see me, right?
Yeah.
I was a lot smaller then than I am now, and I just didn't have it. And I know that. But that's how we build our faith. When we start using the word, and the word works when we use it, it builds that faith. So the next time, I don't have to worry and go, okay, who am I going to call? And spend that 10 minutes standing on the side of the road looking at this thing that I can't fix, when I can say, God's got this. This is nothing but a thing. And pop it. You know? And that goes for everything. You know, there are times in our lives, I think, when we just think, I can't go through this. You know? Whether it be, a personal tragedy or a relationship problem, and you just go, I can't do it anymore. We can. God's got it. He can give us, he gives us, we can do all things through Christ, which gives us strength. That's where it comes from. It's not within ourselves, because, you know, when my dad passed away, it was one of those things that I had people that say, I just don't understand where you're, how strong you are. It's not me. If it was me, I'd be in the corner in a puddle. Trust me. You know, it's God in me that has me standing here in front of you, that can proclaim the gospel at his funeral, that can give an altar call at his funeral. Because if it was up to me, I'm done, right? I want to make sure that everybody understands the God that I know, that tells me I don't have to worry about the fact that my dad is not here. It's a temporary separation for me. I know I'm going to see him again. Let me tell you how you can see him again, too. I would have never had this. This was way before I was a teacher. Way before that, I was like, when he started talking to me about doing it, and I thought, the Lord, I said, oh, no, you got the wrong one. You got the wrong sibling. My brother is the salesman, not me. No, you need to tell him to sell that. No, I'm not. Mm-mm. The Lord said, no, this is for you. This is what I've got for you, and I'm going to give you the strength to do it. And he did. It was not easy, and I had to do my part, because I could have said, nope, not happening. But God. But God. So, he gives us strength when we're weak. In our weakness, he is made strong. So I think we'll close there since it's 8 o'clock, and we'll pick up and do the rest of them in the next lesson. So I appreciate everybody hanging out with me. Pastor, will you close us in prayer?
Sure. Gracious Heavenly Father, Lord, we just love you and we just praise your holy name tonight, Father. Lord, we thank you for this word. God,